So hello friends, welcome back. And in this video we are going to see pore forces round div 2 round 651 problem B. So the problem name is GCD compression. So first of all I will explain the problem statement, what the problem says, and then we will move on to the how to intuit and how to think for this problem, and then we will see the code. So before starting, first of all I would like to say that whenever Ashish Gupta makes the rounds, then it is pretty sure he will involve highly, like you can say, maths would be highly used. So, and especially he loves odd and even numbers, so think for that also. Whenever Ashish Gupta like makes a contest, he's like amazing Indian coder. And yeah, so starting off with the problem, Ashish has an array A of length 2n of positive integers. He wants to compress this array and to make an array B of size n minus 1. And what this array contains is that, first of all, out of this array of 2n elements, he will remove 2 elements. Okay. Then I am remaining with 2n minus 2 elements. So out of these 2n minus 2 elements, he will remove 2 elements one time and add them, and suppose push it in a vector. Suppose he choose 2 elements from this, then he push it in a vector. Now he choose 2 elements from this and push it in a vector, and so on and so forth. So the indexes of these 2 elements, what he chose, the indexes of these 2 elements, what he chose, we need to print these n minus 1, you can say, index of pairs, indexes pairs. Which means, let's suppose take one example. Let's take this example. So example is, we have n equal to 3. So I will have 2 into n, which means 6 elements in my array A, which means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So arbitrarily I can remove any 2 elements in the start, as I clearly said. So let's suppose I remove these 2 elements, and then I will choose 2 elements. Suppose the indexes are marked from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So I choose, suppose I choose these 2 elements. Suppose I choose these 2 elements, these 2. Then I will obtain the sum as 8. And suppose I choose these 2 elements, then I will obtain the sum as 10. So the GCD of these 2 should be more than 1. Okay, very fine. Okay. So now how to think for this problem? Now you will say, like, how to think or how to remove some elements and how to choose some elements. So if you clearly see the constraints, so n is less than equal to 1000. So at first glance you will say, okay, I can run a loop of n square also. But if you see that you need to choose, like, for the particular, first of all you need to remove 2 elements, so you will see that what 2 elements to remove. Then you will see, like, if I'm standing here, then what index to choose. Suppose if I'm standing here, I will have n options to choose from, or basically I can say 2 into n options to choose from. So for every element I have n options. But if I choose this element, then for the other element also I will have to do n options. So it will be n into, like, something like that. So the complexity would be very high if I go something like brute force. So I will not do that. But if I clearly see that I want the GCD of these numbers to be more than 1. So GCD of b1, b2 up to bn minus 1. So here b1, b2 are the sums which I obtained by removing 2 elements from A and then adding their values. Okay. So what I wanted is that the GCD should be more than one. So if you can clearly say that, what suppose Rn if I am able to obtain the GCD as 2. Now why I opted for 2? Like you might ask, we can also have the GCD as 3, 5 or anything. So why you just opted for 2? And why only 2? Why not 4, 6 or something like that? So see, I just wanted one thing. The GCD should be more than 1. Okay. So if I opt for 4, then ultimately the number 2 will be present in it. And if I opt for 6, then ultimately the number 2 will be also present in it. Now if I say that, okay, so why not you opt for 3 or 5 or something like that? So it might also happen that I opt in the GCD as this. So I will say no. Why no? Because see, when I have some numbers, suppose I have numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So the numbers, either they can be odd or the numbers they can be even. Okay. So the numbers are odd or the numbers are even. Ultimately, it is the case. Now, I will be having an n. Okay. So n will be some number and I will do 2 into n. So 2 into n is always even. Understanding? 2 into n is always even. Okay. So 2 into n minus 2 is also even. Understanding? So I will have some numbers. Suppose number of odd numbers are O. For now, let's represent number of odd numbers as O. Number of even numbers as E. So in total, number of odd numbers plus number of even numbers, how many numbers are there? 2 into n numbers. Understanding? See, either the number can be odd or even. So number can be odd or number can be even. And that numbers in total I have is 2 into n. So I clearly know that 2 into n is even. So the number of odd numbers and the number of even numbers, what O represents? It represents number of odd numbers. What E represents? Number of even numbers. So if O and O plus E is even, which means number of odd numbers plus number of even numbers is even. So what is the case when the sum of two numbers A plus B is even? Either both A and B are even or both A and B are odd. Understanding the case this? So the sum of two numbers, they can be even only when either both are even or both are odd. Okay, fine, very fine. So I will never have a case when A is odd, B is even, or A is even, B is odd. Because if it is the case, then the sum will be odd, but I am always having the sum as even. Okay, because it is this. So either it is even, or it is odd. Now, if let's suppose have the case this, when both are even. If number of odd numbers and number of even numbers both are even, so what will happen? See, if number of odd numbers and number of even numbers both are even, so let's for better understanding, let's mark some numbers. So number of odd numbers are, let's suppose, 4, and number of even numbers are, let's suppose, 2. So first of all, I had an option to remove two numbers in the start. So either I can remove these two, or I can remove, suppose, these four numbers and here are numbers 2, or I can remove these two. Now you will say, Arun, how will you check which two numbers to remove? So see, I can say that I can remove any two numbers from either these two, or I can remove any two numbers from even numbers. Now, how I'm saying that? See, if the number is odd, so odd plus odd is always even. And if the number is even, so even plus even is also always even. And the number of odd numbers are also even, which means that odd plus odd plus odd plus odd plus odd plus odd, it would be something like that, which means even plus even plus even. Okay. So it is always even, and it will be always even. Now, you must be thinking, why I'm only focusing on even? See, if I can obtain a number which is even, then I can write that particular number as 2 into something. And if I can write that as 2 into something, so 2 is the GCD of it. At least I can obtain 2 as a GCD of it. That's why I am focusing on to write a number as a multiple of 2. Okay, very fine. So let me erase this back. So, okay. Let me check if the recording is fine. Going fine. Okay, encoding overloaded. I don't know why it is happening. Let me check the processors. So, yeah. Okay, fine. So, if I am up till here that I can remove any two numbers from odd numbers and any two numbers from even numbers. Now, it might also happen that first of all, I will choose to remove any two numbers from this particular even number. So what will happen? All these numbers will be gone. And then I will choose. See, as I need to print the indexes. So I will have a vector which will store the indexes of odd numbers. And I will have a vector which will store the indexes of the even numbers. Now, first of all, I will remove two elements from my even number always. You can also remove two elements from the odd number, but for simplicity and for a like pattern, I am removing two numbers from the even number. Now, what can happen? If I remove these two numbers, then it might happen that it might also have few more numbers which are like even in count. So what I will do, I will just write them in pairs. Like I will opt for these two, I will opt for these two, which means I will push in my vector. Like I will have for the final answer, I will have a vector of pairs of suppose int comma int, suppose it is v. So I will push v, I will push v dot push back, I will push these two indexes, which is I and I plus 1 for this particular vector in which I stored the indexes. So by the code it would be more clear, but for understanding of now, you just see that I am pushing the indexes of the even numbers. Okay, by this I will push all the indexes of these even numbers, and then I will push all the indexes of these odd numbers. Now you might ask, okay Aaron, when the number of odd numbers and when the number of even numbers, when both were even, so you opted to remove any two elements from any one of these, either odd or either even. But what if both are odd? Because the case which was remaining here, it is C, as you can see. So what if both are odd? So now let's take that case. So number of odd numbers and number of even numbers when both are odd. It is also odd. It is also odd. So how it will represent? I will represent it as something like this. These two, suppose these two and one. So odd elements I have here. Okay. So you can say odd elements. Okay. And here also I will write something like this. Suppose I have odd elements. So I can clearly see from here that I have odd elements in here. I have odd elements in here. But as I clearly know that odd plus odd is even. But if I do something like that, odd plus odd, plus odd plus odd, plus odd, then it is even. It is even, which is even. But even plus odd, it is odd. But I never wanted something to be odd. As I clearly said that I wanted even so that I can make it as something 2 into GCD and it will always be even. So I don't want odd. So I clearly know that I can remove two elements. So I will just do what? I will remove this element. I will remove this one element from here. I will remove this one element from here. And thus, now what I will do? I will do the same procedure. I will opt for these two elements from in here. I will push it in my, vector of pairs which I made above. And what are these basically? These are representing the indexes of the even numbers. And what are these? These are representing the indexes of the odd numbers. And I will similarly for them also, I will push them in my vector of pairs, like one by one, like in a form of pair, so that finally I will obtain my answer in my vector of pair V. And then I will simply, you know, print my vector of pair. So I hope that you guys got it, and I wish that it might not have stuck up till now, because this glitch format comes on when it is stuck. But yeah, I hope that. So I hope that you guys got the logic. So the code is also pretty simple, although I wrote it a bit longer, but I think that it can be written simpler. But yeah. So first of all, I input my test cases. Then I have my n. Then I input my array. I have this, although it is not required pretty much, because even ultimately I am pushing in my vector, and to have the size of even and odd, I can just odd I dot size and even I dot size, but still I have another variable for them. Then I just input my array A of I, and I check if the number is even, then I push its index in my array called even I. If it is odd, then I push in my index called odd I. Now I will have my vector of pairs to store my final answer. As I clearly said that if both even and odd are even in number, which means the count of elements which are even and the count of elements which are odd are both even, then I will apply my logic which I stated in like here. Which I stated you guys here. And when else in the case when both are odd, then I will apply the logic which I stated here. So now what I can do, either I can remove two elements from even or, but it might happen that even has size 0, which means that even the array of even numbers is not there, only we have odd numbers. So I have to remove two elements from odd numbers. Okay, so if my even is not 0, which means the size of even number array is not 0, then I will try to remove my elements, two elements, starting two elements from, you know, even array, which means even of I. And for the remaining elements, which means I have removed indexes 0 and 1, so I'm starting from index 2. I will move up to the size, and I am doing plus 2 because I am pushing two indexes, which means I and I plus 1, and it is storing what? So it is storing what? It is storing the indexes. Okay, fine. Then what I am remaining is, I am remaining with the odd array. So I will iterate from 0 because now I have removed two elements already from even, so I don't need to remove two elements from odd now. So I will start from 0, and similarly which I did for the even, I will do the same for odd. Now it might happen that number of elements which are even are 0, so I have to remove two elements from the odd one. So I remove the two elements from the odd one, which means I start from index from 2, and I did the same thing for this also. Else, what is this else case? Else case is that when the count of even numbers and the count of odd numbers both are odd, and if that is the case, then I will just remove two, you can say, I will just remove two values, which means one from odd and one from even. So I start from 1 and I removed 0, I equal to 0. And I start from 1 here also, I left out I equal to 0. And similarly, I will push them as I did in the above. Then finally, I have my answer in my vector of pairs, and I will just print out my pairs in this form, like v.first, pair.first and v.second. So I hope that you guys So I hope that you guys got the logic, and that was pretty much it. And it was just a simple game of even and odd, and to think, okay, I have to make an even number, I have to make a GCD, which is something like this, and so on and so forth. So I hope that you guys got it, and if not, then I will clearly recommend to move back just 8 to 9 minutes back and just try to rewatch that 8 to 9 minutes. It would be most obvious to understand that particular length of topic. And yeah, that's it for this video. If you guys enjoyed the video, then please hit the like button, and yeah, do see the next problem. Thank you very much for watching this video. See you guys in the next video. Bye.